In this video, I will show you how you can get selected values from drop-down boxes, like selected text. This was one of your questions, and question was, hey Martin, do you do JavaScript? And if yes, could you please show me how to get text from JavaScript drop-down box? And by using this method, which I will show you right now in this video, you will be able to get values from any elements on your HTML page. However, I will be showing and demonstrating this in this video on select boxes. I could show you on paragraphs or any other elements which you have on HTML page. So let's go, guys, and I will show you how it is done. I have pre-written here's HTML page. There's nothing like there's opening. This is HTML5 declaration tags, and we have HTML bodies, and we have head tag where I have included title JavaScript, and then I have created three, like this is one drop down, and here I have Volvo. And this is another drop down. Here I will, let's change this first one, actually not Volvo, but I will delete this and I will change it to Mercedes. This doesn't really matter what you are adding there, so this will be Mercedes, and the last one will add Audi. And then I will show you how it looks on page, and then I will show you quickly how you can do it in JavaScript and how you can get this. And I will not be rushing, so you understand everything what I am doing. And we have three drop-down boxes, 1, 2, and 3. And first we have Volvo, in second one we have selected value Mercedes, and in third one we have Audi, because I don't have any select another option which is empty at the very top of any of them. And now I will run this file in Chrome, as I'm using Chrome, guys. Volvo, and we have Saab, Mercedes, Audi, and then we have Mercedes, and then we have Audi. Now is the question, how we can get these values? So guys, let's go back to our, this is my, I'm using Notepad++, and probably most of you know, guys, that Notepad++ is one of the most popular scripting. I actually like it because I like writing code, because I find it very useful and easy to use. Let's write JavaScript at the very bottom of the page. And guys, yes, whenever you write a JavaScript, try to always include it at the very bottom of the page, because if you are included at the top of the page, in some cases then JavaScript have to load first, and page content is not getting loaded in time because you have heavy JavaScript files, for example, for big applications at the top. So always include your JavaScript or jQuery, which is pretty much JavaScript as well, JavaScript functions library, at the very bottom of the page. So as if you include it at the top of the page, JavaScript is not able to read all page before it is loaded. So always include it at the very bottom and you will be okay. So let's write script opening tag, script opening tag, and script closing tag. All you will need to do is to create one variable. So let's create variable, and I will call this variable L. You can call it however you want. I call it L, and I will assign directly to this variable. I will tell this variable that I want to store particular tag values in this variable. Get document, okay, and then you are opening closing brackets, and in these brackets you are writing in elements which you would like to get. And in our case, we want to get or target these select elements, because these are select elements, and this is what we want to target. So we say get elements by tag name, and we write select. Next thing what we want to do is to check how many elements are on page, and now all elements will be stored in this variable L. So to check it fast, we simply go alert, okay, and then we go L dot length, We are using JavaScript function dot length, like length function, to get how many elements are in there, and we will alert it out. So let's save it, and let's now go back to our browser and refresh this page, and we are getting 3 elements, and this means that there are 3 drop down boxes on our screen. If we would add another one, then there would be 4. If you refresh this page, you see it's alerting 3. If we go back and let's say I will copy and paste another drop down box, so we created another drop down box. So let's save, let's go back to page, refresh this, and you see it's showing 4. However, it's not even displayed, but there are 4 already. This means that this works. And now we have all these elements. We have access to all of these 4 elements. However, I will remove these 4s which I created, because there's no point having 4 if 3 is more than enough. So I refresh and we are back to 3. And I go back to our script. And now we will show you how you can get value, selected value. As you see, first value which is selected is Volvo in first drop-down box. In second drop-down box we have Mercedes, and in third drop-down box we have Audi. And in this way, like I said guys, you can get values from any HTML page. If you just write this one simple line, you write this line, and here instead of select, for example, if you would want to get radio button feel collections or checkbox collections or paragraphs even, you simply write here the tag name in it. Like if it would be paragraph, you would insert here instead of select P, and then you can access all objects, paragraph objects, how many are in your page, and then you can start working. And this is getting saved here as an array. It is here. And now if you would want to get values, then simply as an array, guys, as you probably know from basics, arrays work like this, simple as this is square bracket, and then we are adding array number. And as you know guys, array starts not from 1, but they are starting from 0. So the Volvo stored value will be 0. So we go 0, and then at the end we are adding dot value. This means that we want to get arrays, first arrays, which is 0 value, displayed in our alert. And I will save this and I will show you straight away that it works, and now Volvo will be displayed whenever I will refresh this page. As you see guys, Volvo is displayed. And now if I would want to get, for example, last drop-down boxes selected value, I would go for 2, because this is 0, 1 and 2. And now we will get displayed in alert box to Audi. So let's save it, let's go back, let's refresh this page again, and as you see, Audi is getting displayed. And this is JavaScript built-in function which allows you to get any objects on the page by their tag name. All it is get elements by tag name. From here, once you have it, this variable, now you know guys, you probably know how to use for loops and how to display values from for loops by using for loops or while loops or do while loops. Now you can do everything what you want with these. So let's do it, and if someone values whenever you are collecting them. I could show you straight away for those who are interested how you could get paragraph texts, for example, and display them. Paragraph 1, and I will create 3 of them. Control D, D, and this will be paragraph 2, and this will be paragraph 3. Okay, and now I am getting L, document that get element, instead of select, I will add P. Now I'm getting all paragraph tags and storing them in L value. I could rename this variable's name to paragraph. Okay, you can call it as ever you want. Like I will copy it, now we will go here and I will paste it in here, paragraph second. So first this will be 0, 1 and 2, so second will be paragraph 3, will be alerted out. So let's save it, let's go back to our page, refresh it, and this is undefined. Okay, and now we have paragraph 1, 2, 3, and we refresh. This is P dot value. dot inner HTML, inner HTML, dot inner HTML, guys, sorry, because this is paragraph, this is not a select box. Okay, now let's go. And as you see, we are displaying paragraph 3 here, value, because this is second one. And like I mentioned, dot value you are writing for form elements, for other elements which are not form elements. Like form elements would be like checkboxes, radio, buttons, and so on and so forth, whatever you can put within web form which you are adding. For all others, you are using dot inner HTML because those are simple elements like paragraphs, links, and header tags, like I mentioned before, and so on and so forth. And but note that this is very important to understand, that this get element by tag name, it allows you to get all elements on the page which you are defining, which elements you want to get, and then you just store them in this whatever variable you want, and then you use that variable in loops as an array and get values from elements which you want, and you can display them and do with them whatever you like. So for example, now I would like to display this on the screen instead of alerting. So in that case, I do document doc, sorry, by ID, this forward so it's not on the way, dot get element by ID. We will need to create some element on the page, so I will create another paragraph or div tag. You can create it whatever you want and give him ID here, div, and I will give ID here, okay, here. And so get element by ID, so we are getting this particular div element because we will be displaying in this element. And I will add here, okay. And in inner HTML, I will add this paragraph. So I will say after here, dot inner HTML is equal to this paragraph 2. Control X, I will add it here, guys. Control V, will delete this thing. And as you see, now we will be displaying in this div element, this doc, because we are getting it by document get element by ID here. In inner HTML, this means inside of it, between opening and closing div tag, this value from paragraph 2, this value which is here, 0, 1, 2, second paragraph element. Let's save it. Let's go back to our screen. Let's remove this. Let's refresh page. And as you see, we have here at the very bottom paragraph 3. So yes, guys, this is it, how you can get values or text values or selected values from all elements on your HTML pages. So if you found this video useful, leave a like, share this video, subscribe to my channel, and see you in my other videos. And in comments, by the way, just ask if you are interested in something else.